Hi everybody, welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to cook another keto dish or gluten-free dish, whichever you want to call it. We're going to make a noodle-less lasagna or a crustless pizza. We're going to make a ricotta cheese blend with ricotta cheese, oregano, and one egg. I'm going to use two packages of Italian sausage. This is mild Italian sausage. Each one's 19 ounces, but if you can find the tube, that's okay too. I'm also going to use about a half a pack of pepperoni. These are totally optional. We'll get into that in a minute. I'm going to use a half a bag of turkey meatballs. These are not Italian seasoned. These are just some great value turkey meatballs. I'm going to use one red onion sliced, one white onion sliced, one green, red, and yellow bell peppers sliced. I'm also going to use a 10-ounce pack of portobello, baby bella mushrooms, also sliced and cleaned. And then I'm going to add some garlic. I'll show you that there's varieties of garlic. We're going to also add some black olives. Jimmy really likes black olives on his pizza, so I wanted to add this as a touch to him. And then a little bit of Italian blend seasoning with the oregano, and I'll show you what we're going to do with that. And then I'm using Classico. This is the lowest carb sauce that I can find here in my town, but use whatever sauce you want to use, even homemade is fine. And then a tiny bit of olive oil. And then we're going to use some mozzarella cheese. My dad always used the combination of whole milk and skim milk mozzarella cheese when he made his lasagna. So I'm going to stick with that. And then we're going to use a casserole dish as big as you want, depending on what you're going to put in it. So as you guys know, if you're new to my channel, hi, my name is Jerrianne. I have a sort of a really rough case of arthritis, but I have physical limitations that make it harder for me to cook at the stove for long periods of time. So we're going to do a lot of cooking at the table. We do a lot of prep and cooking at the table. So what I'm doing here is I'm making the ricotta blend. Now, my dad taught me how to make this ricotta blend when we were making lasagnas. My whole life growing up, it was a New Year's Day tradition. So what I have here is a 15-ounce container of ricotta cheese. If you noticed, it's kind of hard for it to come out. So what he always taught me to do is turn the container over, whack it with the knife just to release that vacuum, and then it dumps right out. The only reason I had to scoop it is because I didn't actually rip the plastic off properly. My bad. So what we're going to do is just going to take that container, the one egg, and then one teaspoon to one tablespoon of oregano. Again, this is a personal preference. I would say minimum of a teaspoon. This is whole dry oregano. If you're going to use fresh, you always have to up it because dry is always more concentrated in flavor. Okay, and then you're just going to whisk this together and let it set to the side. We're just going to let these flavors amalgamate. He never added any garlic or anything to it, just the egg and the oregano. But if you wanted to up the flavor profile of your cheese, you could. We're going to use also that I didn't take a picture of, and I'm sorry, we're also going to use Parmesan cheese as a sprinkling in the layers as well. So this is the Italian sausage. It's really difficult for me to find a tube of Italian sausage here that is just a bulk tube. So what I do is I buy the packages and I just take the skins off, which is just easy. I just slice down each one, peel them all off, set the skins to the garbage, and then put the meat, just basically the insides of the sausage, and we're going to brown that up. Now, how much sausage, what type of sausage, or not even sausage if you don't want, is really entirely up to you. Basically, if you're making this a crustless pizza, it's basically you're just going to bake your favorite pizza toppings. If you're going to make this a lasagna, having the variety of meats is also just makes it really, really good. It ups the flavor levels that we always had when we were growing up. My dad even put hard-boiled eggs in lasagna. I know it sounds crazy. It's so stinking delicious. I can't even imagine where he thought of it, but anyhow, I digress. So we're going to prep everything. I've already sliced both onions, as you saw, and sliced all three bell peppers. I've set them in a bag. I've cleaned and sliced the mushrooms already because you guys have watched us cook before, and just this is going to take a long time to cook and assemble, so I didn't want to waste footage of me slicing and prepping. So we're going to brown the sausage in the Instant Pot. I turn the Instant Pot on saute. And I let it heat up for a little bit before you put the meat in. This way it doesn't stick as much. Now sausage, I will tell you, I use my macerator. It does like to stick to bulk sausage, whether it's the Italian sausage or whether it's breakfast sausage. The fat in the sausage is just really likes to stick to that. My sister calls it a spatulator, the meat chopper. But I like to call it a macerator or a meat chopper. But my sister... Anyway, I don't know why I was talking about my sister because she calls it something different. But anyway, I noticed that when I was making the sausage in the past, the sausage fat, as you can see there, really likes to stick to this. So I just take a rubber spoonula, spatula, scrape it off, put it back in. And you don't have to do this a lot. You just want to make sure that you break up your pieces. And then we're going to switch to the wooden, flat, wooden bamboo thing that I got Jimmy, which I absolutely love. It's like a straight edge spatula. And it really helps me clean all of the fond off the bottom of the Instant Pot. Okay? Now, I'm not going to show you this entire browning process because it really does take a long time to cook down all this sausage. But I will show you that I did up the heat. Now, my Instant Pot has a saute button, and you can adjust the level of the heat from the saute. You have a more, a less, and a less, a more, and a normal. Less, normal, and more. That's what it is. So I just, you hit the saute button to adjust the temperature on this particular. This is an Instant Pot Duo. So just read your directions on how to do that for your Instant Pot. And voila, the meat is browned. So I have sort of a slotted collection ladle thing. I'm not really sure what you call it. But as you can see, I'm letting all of that grease and liquid drip off. Well, most of it. You'll see some of it. You could stand there all day and sift it and there still would be a lot. But the Instant Pot is still on. So I don't want to take a really long time to have that meat cook too much because I don't want it to overcook because it's still going to bake in the oven. Okay. So we just wanted to get all the pink off of it. It doesn't have to be dark brown. It doesn't have to be any like singed, seared pieces because again, it's going to bake longer in the oven. But we want to just make sure it's cooked through, okay? Now we're going to set it off to the side with the grease that's in the pot. Remember, we didn't add any oil. This is just the grease that came off the sausage. We're going to go ahead and brown the onions. Some of the peppers went in there, but that's okay. I'm just fishing them out. Whenever we saute onions, remember, you always have to add a little salt. The reason we do that is because the salt draws out the liquid of the onions and helps them caramelize better, helps them cook down faster, okay? This is not, surprisingly so, this is not a salty dish, even though we salt the vegetables as we're cooking them. They can really take the salt as well, all right? So I just want to get these to be translucent, just translucent. Again, I don't want tons of color on this. Think about when you're having pizza. Your onions that are on top of your pizza are usually not pre-cooked. They usually just bake in that really intense oven. However, we're pre-cooking them because we are not baking in an intense heated oven. Plus, these are going to be inside the layers, so we wanted to have it cooked, so we won't have raw onions going out throughout our lasagna or pizza, whichever way you want to talk about it. Now, I mentioned before that you don't have to use sausage if you don't want to. You can use turkey Italian sausage if you want to, if you want to make this pork-free. You don't have to use the pepperoni. You can use salami. You can use Canadian bacon. You can use regular bacon, chicken, ham. Whatever it is that you like on your pizza, you can bake without a crust in this dish. I want to tell you a little bit of background. I got kidnapped to Georgia by my bestie, and we went to her niece's house. She ordered me this crustless pizza from Mario's Pizzeria. It was amazing. I had no idea such a thing existed. I got like the garbage pie or the deluxe, and basically what it was a pan full of all the pizza toppings. It was fantastic. Then I went to go when I was in Texas, kidnapped from Georgia to Texas. I went to Eden's house and Eden made a very similar thing. I turned her on, I told her about it. I suggested it and she looked up recipes and found one and thought it was really good. So I wanted to go ahead and make my version just a little bit different. I actually texted her when I was ready to make this and I said, how do you think ricotta cheese would taste in that? And she's like, you know what? I think it would taste pretty good. So we did the same thing with, we took out the onions just when they started to be clear. And then I added the mushrooms. Now, the reason I didn't add the peppers right away is because I like the way onions and mushrooms taste together. So I actually left little pieces of onion in the bottom of the pan. But it was also a little too dry. So what I did was I drained off some of the oil off of the sausage and some of the oil off the onions back into the pot. After it settles in the bowl a while, it's very easy just to take that slotted spoon, hold back the meat, and pour the liquid in. And then I was able to use that to deglaze the pan of all the mushroom bits. The mushrooms, very meaty. Even if you don't like mushrooms, you really can't notice them very much in this dish, but I love mushrooms. Oh, I love mushrooms. I'm sorry. I know that there's people who love them and people who hate them. So if you're a lover, go ahead. If you're not, hey, Try it anyway. No, I'm just kidding. You don't have to. But just like I said, your favorite piece of toppings. Leave out, put in whatever you like. Okay? Now we're going to add the peppers. I'm going to do the same thing with the peppers. I'm going to get some of that sausage juice, some of that onion grease, and I'm going to drain that back into with the peppers. And again, with a little salt. Because just like the onions, we want to draw some of that liquid out of the peppers, and we want to help them cook down a little faster. Now, I will tell you, you don't want to cook these all the way either. This is just like the onions, just like the mushrooms. We want to let everything be a little toothy. We don't want to cook it down too much. Then it just becomes like, I don't know, like a casserole of, or like a stir fry almost. I wanted it to keep everything in like layers, make it nicey nice, that kind of thing. I think I went so fast, I forgot to tell you that I added the equivalent of 3 cloves of garlic to the onions when I was sauteing them. And I just added about a tablespoon of onion powder to the peppers. And the reason I did that is because minced onion or fresh onion and onion powder have different flavor levels. I know we've talked about this a lot. And together they make a really great combination. So I'm just letting this onions, the peppers cook down a little bit. If you'll hear in a second, the Instant Pot will actually go off. There you go, that little beep. Because the saute button will saute for 30 minutes and then it'll shut itself off. So that's kind of a really good safety feature that they do have. Now, don't leave it on purpose. But if you ever actually did leave it, you'll be safe enough to know that it's going to shut itself off after 30 minutes, okay? And we're just going to deglaze the pot once more, collect up all of the peppers, and then we're going to get ready to assemble. Now, I mentioned the jar sauce before. There is a really low-carb jar sauce called Rao's, R-O-A or R-A-O. I think it's, I don't know, but it's quite expensive, to be honest with you. And it does, you can get it as low as 3 carbs per serving, which is a half a cup. This one is 5 carbs per serving. So it's not terrible, and it's classico, and it's like $2 a jar. Plus, you get this really cute mason jar when you're done. I'm just saying. But they actually, Classico does make a 5-carb sauce. It is the roasted pepper. The roasted pepper has 5 net carbs. So what I've done is I've taken the meatballs. They were frozen. And I just popped them in the microwave, a half a bag of meatballs for 60 seconds. I don't want them cooked. I just wanted them to be defrosted enough to slice. Slicing all my meatballs, just 4 slices per meatball. They're kind of small. But I'm kind of trying to leave them like at least 1/4 inch thick. You know, just a little to make a nice layer when I'm ready to do the meat layer. Now, when we made family lasagnas, when we were young, it was like 2 different kinds of lasagnas with and without egg. But as the kids got older and as the in-laws became more plentiful, my dad started making more customizable lasagnas. This one didn't have sausage. This one didn't have mushrooms. This one didn't have egg. This one just had meat. So we've learned to grow and adapt. Now, these turkey sausage from Great Value actually have carbs in them. They each meatball has 1 carb. So if you want to cut your carbs down even further and make it completely gluten-free, go ahead and make your own meatballs. We have recipes on our channel when we did keto meatballs, I think. Yeah, we use ground up pork rinds instead of breadcrumbs, and it works fantastic. And now we're just going to get started. This sauce is 6 grams of net carbs per half a cup. So I'm using 1/4 cup at a time. We're going to just use we're just going to use 1 whole cup through the whole thing. So 2 servings, it's going to be 12 carbs for the sauce in the whole entire dish. Now, if you get lower carb sauce and you want to add more, or you make homemade sauce, you can add more. That's entirely up to you. This is what I had to work with, and this is what I'm working with. So I'm going to take half of my sausage and put it on the first layer. First, we put down 1/4 cup of sauce, and we do this so it doesn't burn, and we can basically scoop it from the bottom. It just makes a nice seal. That was for Barry Lewis, sorry. So we're going to take half of our... I have like ADD today, sorry. And that's true, but anyway, we're going to take half of our sausage. I'm going to spread it evenly across the bottom. Now, how you layer it is just as important as what you layer it with, but it's food. You're going to taste it. It's going to be delicious either way. But to keep it together is one of the reasons why we do it the way we do it. So we're going to do meat, cheese, toppings, meat, cheese. We're always going to do those combinations. So what I've done is I've just taken the whisk and I've filled the whisk and I've splattered some of the ricotta cheese all over and I'm rubbing it. Now, you don't want to rub it too harshly, but you'll see it is quite smooth when you add the egg to it. It does spread out nice and smooth. We want to just try to get it as all over as possible because it will melt down into that sausage layer. Yum. Then we're going to take our mozzarella cheese. So what I decided to do was when we would make this with my dad, it would be like real paleo, shred your own. That does not exist here in Rolla anywhere in all of the stores. So we have to go with what we have. So what I've done is I've taken the bag of part skim and the bag of whole, and I'm trying to mix them together so I can have a blend going out throughout each layer. Okay. We're going to do meat, ricotta cheese, mozzarella cheese, and then sprinkle Parmesan. Of course, I didn't get a big enough bowl, so I have to improvise. But that's no problem. When we do lasagnas, you definitely have to wash your hands because this is a hands-on project. Now, if you were putting noodles in this lasagna, you would do sauce, noodle, and then the meat layers, and then a noodle, then the cheese, then a noodle layer, and then the meat, and then the cheese, and then the noodle. And that's how you would do it, top it off with sauce. But, of course, this is noodle-less. What I'm doing now is I'm adding the peppers and onion layer. So I'm doing half of the onions and half of the peppers. And I'm kind of layering them on top of each other because I like that pepper and onion combination. And now we're going to do a little bit of the sauce. This sauce is going to melt down on top of that cheese and on top of those peppers and onions. Okay. Now, if you want to add oregano to your peppers and onions when you're sauteing them, you can. I didn't because I added the Italian seasoning to the onions when I was cooking them down. Or the sausage. I added to the sausage when I was cooking it down. I take that back. And now on top of the peppers and onions, we're going to layer our meatballs. Now, this is a half a bag of meatballs, like I mentioned. I don't know exactly how many. Go back and you can count me, cut them. But I'm just going to put them all on the layer. I'm trying not to overlap, but I'm trying not to leave any spaces either. Because we're not using noodles, the tighter we pack our meat, then the better it will hold together. And I will tell you from experience tonight, making it for myself for the first time, that it actually cooled off about a half an hour and it sliced perfectly and it was still very hot. But it sliced so much better. It held together so much better. If you can just manage to let it cool off for 30 minutes, that's the most difficult part. Okay. And now on top of the meatballs, we're going to put the mushrooms. Again, this was just the way we always did it at home. Sometimes my dad had a meatball layer. Sometimes he had just meat sauce layer, but most of the time he tried to make meatballs as well. So it was always the meatballs with the mushrooms on top. And now I did forget to put sauce down, but I didn't like to, I should take that back. I didn't forget to put sauce down. If you can afford the carbs for the sauce, put sauce down on top of this ricotta cheese. I was trying to lessen it, so I left it out of this layer. Okay, does that make sense? So now I've added the ricotta cheese and then the black olives. I should have put the black olives under the cheese, but I forgot, so forgive me. But it's okay, it works really well together right there anyway. So I put the ricotta cheese and spread it, all of the whole can of black olives. It is a small can. And now we're gonna add the mozzarella. So we put a third down in the first layer. We're putting the second third down in this layer. And then we're going to put the rest on the very, very top. You shouldn't really end with cheese. My father always said you don't end with cheese, but we're not having a noodled lasagna. So we're ending with cheese to kind of create a top crust. Normally you end with the noodle with the sauce on top so that it doesn't just burn the cheese on top. But this is what we're doing because this is what we got. Okay. Now, whenever I add the Parmesan cheese and the mozzarella cheese, I try to like pat it down a little bit just to flatten the layers. And otherwise, you can kind of end up sometimes with a hump in the middle if you're not careful. If you're not an expert, I got air quotes going on here. So then we're going to add the second rest of the sausage, not the second layer, the second portion of sausage. And now we're going to put the pepperoni on top. Again, this is only about a half a bag. I don't like spicy, and when the pepperoni cooks down, it does get a little spicy. So keep that in mind if you're not a spicy person. It's not too objectionable to me, but it may be for you. If you like pepperoni on your pizza, then it's already cooked down pepperoni. If you like that, this is just basically the same thing. So we're going to put down that layer of pepperoni. Again, if you have other meats you want to do, it's entirely up to you. Other pizza toppings, you need to go for it. I think it would be amazing. So I'm trying to just get one layer again without a lot of holes, without any holidays, without overlapping too much, but just filling it in and washing my hands as I go on my clean rag and dry towel. Okay, and now the rest of the onions and peppers. Well, peppers first, then onions. And then we're going to top it off with the rest of our onions. And at this point, you can see I'm using my hands and I'm draining the excess liquid into the bowl because I don't want it to be too watery in the lasagna or meat or pot pizza, deep dish pizza. I don't know. Italian meat bake? What would you guys call this? I don't know. So now I'm going to take the rest of the ricotta cheese and just try to spread it all over the best I can. And again, you know me, I love to scrape a bowl. I hate to leave food left behind. No production assistant here on this Food Network channel. So I'm just going to use that to spread as much all over as we can. Now you can always use more ricotta cheese. When we used to make batches of lasagna, we used to use tons of ricotta cheese, like 8, 9 pounds, like nine, no, two, four, six, two, four, six pounds of ricotta cheese because they're 32-ounce containers. You used to use 3 32-ounce containers. It was crazy. So then I add the sauce, spread out the sauce, and then add the Parmesan cheese. Again, so this is just a half a cup of sauce on the top. So we use a quarter cup underneath, a quarter cup in the middle, and then a half a cup on top, which is two portions of this particular sauce. So the sauce is only adding 12 net carbs to this whole dish. And this dish is way more than 12 portions. Way more than 12 portions. Okay? Then we add the rest of the mozzarella cheese and some more Parmesan. Now, this is a Lit It Baker from Temptations. So underneath the pan is an actual lid that you could use as a baking dish or as a separate lid. But I like to use it to just, see, flatten out the meat, the lasagna, the pizza crust, or whatever you want to call it. Now we're going to cover it with foil. I get a nice big piece of foil. You want to wrap it loosely around the cheese, but tightly around the ends. And what we're going to do now, I'll show you, is we're going to grab a pinch in the middle. We're going to pull up the tent pole, basically. And what we're doing that for is because we don't want the cheese to all stick to the top of the foil. Now we're going to put it in our preheated oven, 350 degrees, and we're going to bake it for 20, no, 30 minutes, excuse me, with the foil on, and then 20 minutes with the foil off. Okay? And here's my assistant taking the foil off for me at the 30-minute mark. Thank you, assistant. And now we're going to bake it for an additional 20 minutes with the foil off. He's so cute, isn't he? And now we're going to turn the oven off, but leave that in there for 10 minutes. Okay? And like I said, you should let it rest a full half hour if you could, but I could not. At this point, I had to have some. This was hours in the making. So what you can do is you're going to serve it like a lasagna, or you could serve it like a casserole. You can either spoon it in a bowl or you can cut out slices. But this is how it looks when it's all done. Yummy and delicious. So delicious. I can't wait to make this with some homemade sauce. I really have to get some homemade sauce going. But it was delicious with jar sauce, so I can't imagine it's only going to be that much better with homemade sauce. But Jim's just going to use a spatula and he's going to cut me out a square in the corner. And that's it. So I hope you guys really enjoyed this recipe. Again, I am sharing the meals that I am making. I'm not doing keto diet, but I'm eating low to zero carb because of my diabetes. So If you are interested in these recipes, I always leave a list of the ingredients in the description box down below. I also have a cooking playlist from when I wasn't too worried about all the food that I was eating as much. So I will also have that linked in my channel, which is in the description box down below. So if you guys have any questions, go ahead and leave them in the comment section. Give this video a thumbs up, like, and share with anybody you know might be interested in making this dish or any of my dishes. I appreciate it. And as always, you guys take care. God bless. And we'll see you next time. Bye. And as Lydia says, tutti a tavola a mangiare. Come to the table and eat.